Darlene Robinson, and I'm here in Ohio on November 8th, 2015. My mother came to me in my bedroom the other night, and she told me to come to Ohio to be with my brother Jerry and check on her, my brother Larry, because he was having an operation. And I tossed and I turned. I was like, I don't want to drive. I hate driving around mountains. So I was really worried about coming up here. But I was willing to take that ride by myself. And then I thought I would bring my granddaughter, because I know one thing for sure, two things for certain. My mother loved us, and she told us it was always important for us to be a family. So I wanted to be here because my brother has always been there for me. Even when I didn't know he was looking for me, he was looking for me. So I grabbed Tiffany, who's the monster driver in the family, and I put my granddaughter in the car, and I came on up here because I love my family, and I really love my brothers, because even though I'm older than them, I've always wanted them to be the big brothers. So Jerry, when you go to God and you take that operation tomorrow, you just know you're going to wake up a better man than you were before you went to sleep. If I have to come back up here, I will get back on the highway, because no mountains can keep us apart. And no highway is too long when you love somebody. So and I thought that was like, go shopping, make sure you had everything you needed, so when you come out of this operation, you could eat. You know, and I know your wife is going to take good care of you. So, my first visit to Ohio, I really set and stayed for a while. And I'm glad I'm here. That's all I have. Thank you.
Cut.
I thought I heard you song. Mixed up. Okay, that was my little introduction. So now, yeah, this is not coincidence. So Darlene had a dream on Monday. I had a dream on Monday. My mom told me to get up. And in that dream, I saw my brother Marvin, my sister Debbie at the table, and my mom was at the door, and she was yelling to me. And I was a little boy at the table. And she was like, get up. Jerry, get up. She didn't mean get up from the table. She meant get up spiritually. Get up, because you're about to deal with something. And I understood that. And then when I heard that Darlene was also visited by my mom on Monday, I knew that was not a coincidence. That's God. So for all you people that don't believe in God, there it is in your face. God is always talking to you. And people say, well, he doesn't speak to me directly, and he never will. But he will indirectly. Okay? And so that's living proof of that. So I'm gonna go into the surgery, and I'm gonna get it done, and I'm gonna get better. And then I will be on your ass. You know I will be, so get your shit together. Alright? And that's all I have to say. And now we're gonna move on to some funnier things, some karaoke, you know, family members and what have you. And that's what's up.
Larry Cynthia,
yeah. I'm just gonna talk.
Y'all just talk.
I am Larry Robinson, and this is Cynthia Robinson. I'm here to support my brother in his time of need, and to see my lovely sister that I always looked up to, and my beautiful sister-in-law, Val, and my devilish niece, Tiffany. I love y'all.
Stay in the green.
Do what you gotta do and take care of your business and you'll be alright.
I hope you turn the show okay tomorrow.
That was green.
That was green. And my shoes are all gone and down. So everything will be alright tomorrow.
We love ya. Holla.
Oh, I gotta catch up with my words. Some people live just for the fame.
Yeah, use your mic.
I'm letting that do it. Some people live for the power.
The mic in your mouth.
Yeah. Some people live just to play the game.
Grab the other mic.
Some people think that the physical things define what's within, and I've been there before, but that's life aboard so full. Some people want it all, but I don't want nothing at all. If it ain't you, baby, if it ain't, oh, see? Some people want diamond rings, some just want everything, but everything means nothing if I ain't got you. Some people search for a fountain that promises forever young.
Some people need 3 dozen roses, and that's the only way to prove you love them. Hand me the will on a silver platter, and what good would it be with no one to share, with no one who truly cares? Well, I got ahead of myself. Sorry, Alicia. Some people want it all, but I don't want nothing at all. If it ain't you, baby, if I got you, baby. Some people want diamond rings, some just want everything, but everything means nothing if I ain't got you. Some people want it all, so I don't want nothing at all. If it ain't you, baby, if it ain't you, baby. Some people want diamond rings, but I just want nothing. Some just want everything means nothing if I ain't got you. Alright, that's it.
What you
want to
say?
That's it. Oh, okay. Well, first I need to thank the Robinson Clan, because I've been stressing for so long, and when Darlene called and said she was coming, I was just so relieved, and it's like, okay. And then when your mom was talking to y'all, I was like, okay, he's going to be okay. So I got to get myself okay. I just want to thank Larry, Cynthia, Darlene, especially Tiffany, and Leela. She's here too, but she told me when she sings, her throat hurts, so she don't want to sing. So she said to tell Uncle Jerry she was sorry. But I just want to thank all you guys for coming out and being here for Jerry. We acting like this is his last rites and rituals here. But I do want to say, I appreciate your support. I'm glad you're here. I'm glad I'm not going through this by myself. I just want Jerry to know we're going to be praying for you tomorrow, praying for those doctors, because we already know it's already done, because Lucille Robinson said so. You will be fine. We will be fine. I just want you to know that I love you. I will always love you. I will be here to take care of you. It's going to be a rough 3 weeks, but we will get through it. So I love you.
In Philly, know that we know what's up. Find out, figure it out, but ask somebody. Adios. Goodbye.
Why can't they understand the way we feel? They just don't trust what they can't explain. I know we're different, but deep inside us, we're not that different at all. Pena el verte llorar.